वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज एन रिमोट लर्निंग इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय सेठ विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एफिलिएटेड टू CBSE. मायसेल्फ मृदुला काडदेवरू, मैथमेटिक्स टीचर फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 6th. टुडे लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ रिविजन और रीटीचिंग ऑफ चैप्टर 4 बेसिक ज्योमेट्रिकल आइडियाज. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैड स्टडीड सम ऑफ द डेफिनेशंस अबाउट the concepts which come under geometry as well as polygon. So in today's session we will study about angles, how angles are formed, triangles, quadrilaterals and some basic concepts regarding circle. So children, let's start it. So children, when you observe the figure here, we have an angle POQ. So when two rays starting at a common point, when they start from a common end point, they form an angle. So you can define an angle as it is made up of two rays starting at a common end point, and these rays are called as arms of the angle, and the common end point is called as the vertex. So here the rays of the angle are PO and OQ, whereas the common end point vertex is point O. While naming the angle, the vertex of the angle should be in the middle. Suppose in the given figure, if I want to name this angle, then I will name it as angle POQ, where the vertex formed the point that is should be in the center or middle while naming. Next one is here ray OP and OQ are called as arms or sides of the angle, and O is the vertex of the angle POQ. Next we will study about interior and exterior points of an angle. So angle is mainly divided or separated into three regions. Those are, first one is angle, second is interior of the angle, and third one is exterior of the angle. So children, in the given figure here, which how can you name the angle? Yes, the angle is named as angle ABC. Next one is interior of the angle. We say that interior of the angle is nothing but the point or the region which is inside the angle. You can see the shaded portion here, so it is called as interior of the angle. How many points are lying in this? There are two points, point F and point R. These are lying inside the angle, whereas exterior is outside the angle. How many points are there outside the angle? Point T, point X and point P. These are lying on the exterior side of the angle. So children, I hope is it clear. And there are some points which are lying on the angle. Which are those? Point A, point B and point C. These are lying on the angle. Next we will study about triangles. So children, in this triangle also it is similar to that of the angle. We have interior of the triangle, exterior of the triangle, as well as the triangular region, boundary of a triangle. Triangle is mainly a three-sided polygon. Which are the three sides here? Side PQ, QR and RP. So it is having three sides. Which are the three angles here? Angle PQR, angle QRP and angle RPQ. And three vertices are P, Q and R. Hence we say that a triangle is a three-sided polygon which has three sides, three angles and three vertices. Next, it has an interior and exterior region, and we already named this, which are the three sides, which are the three angles and which are the three vertices. Now next we will study about quadrilaterals. Quadri means four, laterals means sides. So a polygon which is having four sides or four line segments, then that closed curve or a polygon is called as a quadrilateral. It is having four sides, four angles and four vertices. So children, you can name it similarly as we have named in the triangle. Sides are AB, BC, CD and AD or DA. Next, vertices are A, B, C and D. Next one is pair of opposite sides. Which are the opposite sides? AB is opposite to CD, whereas BC is opposite to DA. Similarly, if we consider angles, which are the angles here? Angle A is opposite to angle C, angle B is opposite to angle D. If you want to name a single angle without the three letters, you can name the vertex, that is which is in the middle. Suppose if I want to name angle A, I can name it as DAB or BAD. Or in a simpler terms, you can also name it as angle A. Next is adjacent angle. Adjacent means the angle which comes very next to the given angle. Say if I give angle A, angle A is adjacent to angle B as well as angle D. If you go clockwise or anti-clockwise, which comes very next to it? It is angle B and D. Next we have circles. So children, already you know what is a circle. It is a simple closed curve, but it is not a polygon because it does not contain any line segments. So the concepts which we are going to study mainly is radius, diameter, chord, sector, segment and so on. You have already studied. We will just take a recap on the definitions. So children, when you take your rounder and pencil and make a one fixed point at the center and just rotate your rounder, we get a circle. So this point which is present at a center, that is called as the center of the circle, that is fixed point which is present in the middle. Next one is radius. What is a radius here? From the center, if you draw a line segment to any point on the circumference is nothing but the boundary line which forms your circle. So any line segment which you draw from center to any part of the circumference, it is called as radius. Next we have diameter. Diameter is, it is a line segment which joins any two points on the circle, but that line passes through the center, then that is called as a diameter. So I hope children it is clear about the radius, diameter and circumference. Next we have chord. What is a chord? Chord is nothing but a line segment which joins any two points of a circle. Say we have PA, we have two points and it is joining to the circle, isn't it? So PA is a chord, PB is a chord, and which are the diameters here? PM and AC, which is again joined or extended further, that line is called as a diameter because it is passing through the center. The difference between chord and diameter is diameter passes through the center, whereas chord does not pass through the center. Next we have semicircle. What is semicircle? Whenever the diameter is drawn, then that diameter cuts the circle into two equal halves, and this half, every one half, is called as a semicircle. Next we have sector, segment and arc. What is a sector? It is a region which is present inside the circle, which is formed by or which is enclosed by an arc and two pair of radii. You can see two radii are there and the other side we have an arc, then that portion is called as a sector. Similarly, if you take segment, it is formed by arc and one chord. It is enclosed by a chord and an arc, then that region is called as segment. Arc is nothing but the part of a circumference. It is called as R. So children, just go through these definitions so that the fill-ups and MCQ which come in your this one exam, it will be very easier for you to solve.